Hi guys, good day, it's me, Teacher MJ. Our topic for today class is all about the discount, the sell price, and the selling price. So without further ado, let's do this topic. So before we start with example number one class, is we need to define first what is discount, what is sell price, and what is selling price. Now discount is the reduction in the original price of a commodity, product, or service. Sell price is the final price at which a product or item is sold to a customer after the discounts have been applied, and selling price is the amount of money that a company charges for its product. This is also known as the original price. So to formally understand this one class, let's have some word problems. Let's start with example number one. But before that is we need to know the formula. To get the discount, the formula is equal to original price times the rate of discount. So the rate of discount, it means the percent of the discount. And the sell price, to get the sell price, that would be original price minus the discount. And to get the original price is equal to the sell price all over 1 minus the discount rate. Alright, so let's have some work problems, class, for us to understand this one. Once again, class, if you're dealing with problem solving, the first step that you need to do is you need to understand the problem. And once you understand the problem, you write down the given. Alright, so number one, find the discount and the sell price of a t-shirt that has an original price of 599 pesos if the discount rate is 30%. Alright, you write down the given. So, we have given original price, that's 500. I will just put OP class, original price is equal to, that's 599 pesos. And we have rate of discount, so rate, I will just put ROD, rate of discount is equal to 30%. Now once again, plus you need to convert this one into decimal, because when we multiply original price times the rate of discount, you need to convert percent into decimal. So 30%, to convert that one into decimal, just simply move the decimal point right to left twice. Once again, a whole number 30, the decimal point is always after the number. If this is a whole number, the decimal point is always after the whole number. So the decimal point is here. To convert percent into decimal, just simply move the decimal point right to left twice. 1, 2. Therefore, this is equivalent to or 0.30. This is just the same, class. 30% is equivalent to 0.30. Or if you want, class, you can divide this one, class. 30 divided by 100. You will get 0.30. Use your calculator, 30 divided by 100, that would be 0.30. Or it will take time, plus just simply move the decimal point right or left twice. 1, 2, this will be 0.30. Alright, we're told to find the discount. You're told to find the discount and the sell price. So I will just put SP, sell price, and the discount. So to find the discount, our formula, so discount, I will just put D, discount is equal to original price multiplied by the rate of discount. The rate of discount, that is 0.30. Okay, or let me just write rate of discount, ROD. So the discount original price, that is 599. So 599 times the rate of discount, that is 30%, or we can write this one 0.30. Alright, and just simply use your calculator, class. If the teacher will allow you to use calculator, that would be good thing for you. You can just simply answer this one easily. So this will be 599 times 0.30. And the answer, class, is 179.7. So this will be the discount, class. So this will be the discount. 179.7. And do not forget peso sign. Alright, pesos. Alright, 0.7 pesos. You can write, once again, class, 0.7 and 0.70 is just the same, class. 0.7 and 0.70 is just the same. So you can write 0.70, that's okay. Alright, so to use this one, to multiply this one manually, class, without using your calculator, because there are some teachers, class, that they will not allow you to use calculator. So you need to multiply this one manually. So 0.30. So 0 times 9 is 0, 0 times 9 is 0, 0 times 5 is 0, 3 times 9 is 27, 7, carry 2, 3 times 9 is 27, plus 2, that's 29, 9, carry 2, 3 times 5 is 15, plus 2 is 17. Alright, and then you add. So, bring down 0. 0 plus 7 is 7. 0 plus 9 is 9. Bring down 7, bring down 1. Now, you count the number of decimal places. We have 1, 2. So, 2 decimal places. So, you count the number of decimal places. We have 1, 2. So, we have 2 decimal places. Therefore, from your answer class, starting from this one, always remember that the whole number, the decimal point, is on the last part. You move 2 units class right to left. 1, then 2, point. And this will be our answer class. Same answer class. 179.70. Alright, without using your calculator class. So the discount is equal to 179 pesos 0.70 cents, and the sale price, so to get the sale price is equal to original price minus the discount. So original price, that is, what's the original price? That's correct, that's 500. So let me just ignore the peso sign class. 599 minus 179.70, or you can put peso sign, that's okay. 599 pesos minus 179.70. So we can use our calculator. So 599 minus 179.70. So sorry, 0.70. So the answer is 419.3. So you can put 0 there, 0.30, that's okay. So 419.30 for the sale price. 419.30. That's it, class. All set. That's the answer for number one class. Easy, right? For number one. So you can actually subtract this one class. Once again, class, just in case, class, the teacher will not allow you to use calculator, you can just simply subtract this one class. 599. You add two zeros, class, because our discount, it has decimal. So, minus 179.70. Of course, 0 minus 0 is 0. 0 minus 7, that cannot be. You borrow 1, this becomes 8. This becomes 10. 10 minus 7 is 3. 8 minus 9 cannot be. Borrow 1, this becomes 8. This becomes 18. 18 minus 9 is 9. 8 minus 7 is 1. 5 minus 4 is... No, sorry. 5 minus 1 is 4. Same answer, class. Just in case, class, if the teacher will not allow you to use calculator, you need to subtract this one manually. Alright, let's work on another example, class. Example number 2. Alright, so let's have example number 2. In an appliance store, a mini speaker is marked 20% off if the original amount is 1,050 pesos. Letter A, how much is the discount? Letter B, what is the sale price of the mini speaker? Once again, first thing to do, class, is you need to understand the problem. Once you understand the problem, you write down the given. So our given, we have original price, that is 1,050. So 1,050 pesos. Alright, and we have the rate of discount, that's 20%. So rate of discount, that would be 20%. Once again, class, you convert this one into decimal. So this will be equivalent to, or... just move the decimal point. Once again, 20%. Move the decimal point right to left twice. 1, then 2. This will be 0.20. Alright, and then... alright, so to find the discount, we'll be using the formula. So the discount is equal to original price multiplied by the rate of discount. I will just put ROD, class, rate of discount. So original price, that's 1,050 pesos times the rate of discount, that is 0.20. So let's just use our calculator, class. So 1,050 times 0.20, so that would be 210. Do not forget pesos, class. 210 pesos for the discount. So a while ago, class, we explained this one, multiplying this one manually without using the calculator. This time, class, we will just use the calculator. Alright, and the sale price. So what is the sale price? So sale price, I will just put SP, is equal to original price minus the discount. So original price, that's 1,000. Okay, 1,050 minus 210. So this will be 1,050 minus 210. The answer is sale price, that would be 840 pesos. Do not forget peso sign, class. That's it, class. That's it for example number 2. Easy, right? For example number 2. Now, let's have another example, class. Example number 3. What if the rate or what if the original price is unknown? So, how will we find the original price? Let's have example number 3, class. Alright, so let's work on example number 3. So, Tony purchased a computer table for 1,875 pesos. If the computer table was on sale for 25% off, what was the original price? So, once again, you need to understand the problem. Now, once you understand the problem, you write down the given. So, this is given 1,875 pesos. So, this will be our sale price. Because Tony purchased a computer table that was on sale for 25%. So, therefore, this will be our sale price. So, given we have sale price is equal to 1,875 pesos. And we have the rate of discount, that's 25%. So, rate of discount, that would be 25%. Once again, guys, do not forget to convert this discount, this percent, into decimal. So, this will be equal to, or move the decimal point right to left twice. So, 25%. Move right to left twice, 1, 2. So, this will be 0.25. Alright, and we do have the formula to get the original price is equal to the sale price all over 1 minus the discount rate. So, this will be original price is equal to the sale price. So, let me just write it here. Sale price over 1 minus the discount rate. So, this DOR. So, we have the sale price. That's 1,875 over 1 minus the discount rate. 25%, that would be 0.25. 1 minus 0.25. is equal to 1,875 over, so 1 minus 0.25, of course, there would be 0.75. And just simply divide this one, class. Okay, simply use your calculator to find that answer. So this will be 1,875 divided by 0.75. And the answer, class, original price is equal to 2,500. Do not forget peso sign, class. That's it, class. Original price is 2,500. All set for example number 3. Easy, right? For number 3, just use this formula, class, if you are looking for the original price. Sale price divided by 1 minus the discount rate. Alright, let's have last example, class. What if you're looking for the rate? You're looking for the rate of discount. Let's have example number 4, class. Alright, so last example, class. Example number 4. What if you are told to find the rate? So, Mario bought a cell phone for 5,800 pesos. He was given a discount of 1,500 pesos. Find the rate of discount given to him. So, once again, you write down the given. So, given we have 5,800 for the original price. Alright, so given original price. So, I will just put OP. Original price is equal to 5,800 pesos. So, 5,800. Alright, and we have the discount. So, given discount, so the discount is equal to 1,500 pesos. So, this will be 1,500 pesos. Alright, so we can use this formula. We have the discount, we have the original price, and we're told to find the rate of discount. Once again, discount is equal to original price multiplied by the rate of discount, ROD. So to get ROD, to get the rate of discount, okay, we can manipulate this equation, class. To get the rate of discount, we can divide both sides by original price. Alright, so that we can cancel this out. And the remaining equation, class, will be the rate of discount. Therefore, the formula for the rate of discount, so rate of discount is equal to the discount divided by the original price. Okay, so that's the formula class in finding the rate of discount. So the rate of discount, rate of discount is equal to the discount divided by original price. Alright, so the rate of discount, so ROD is equal to the discount plus given 1,500 pesos divide original price, that's 5,800 pesos, so 5,800 pesos, so we can cancel peso sign, alright, to find the rate of discount. So divide plus, use your calculator, so 1,500 divide 5,800. So the answer class is 0 rate of discount is equal to 0.2586 after 6, that's 2. So 0.25862. So we need to have at least 4 decimal numbers. So 25862 after 6, that's 2. We need to round up. Simply copy 6. After 6, that's 2. Simply copy 6. Alright, so 0.2586. Now we need to get the percentage, the percent. So this is decimal. To convert decimal to percent, move the decimal point left to right twice. Okay, so move this decimal point left to right twice to convert decimal to percent. 1, then 2. That's it, plus your answer for the rate of discount. So rate of discount is equal to, move decimal point left to right twice. 1, 2. That would be 25.86%. That's it, plus all set. That's the answer, class, for example number 4. So I hope you learned something new today, class, with regards to discount, sell price, and selling price. If you have some questions, class, with regards to discount, sell price, and selling price, leave a comment, class, on the comment section down below. So once again, I hope you learned something new today. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. You share to your friends and to your classmates so that we can help more students. Once again, this is Teacher MJ. Have a great day, class. Goodbye for now. Bye-bye.